Together we can show the world what we can do. You are next to me and I'm next to you. Pushing on through until the battle's won. No one's gonna give a thing to us. Into each other we put our trust. Standing united after the fight. All alone we will never be. The two of us are holding the key. We see today a world we couldn't. Hi everyone, George here, otherwise known as Power 9 Lord, and today, welcome back to another Top 5 video. So for today's Top 5 video, I'm going to be counting down to you guys my Top 5 favourite movies of 2021, and I'm actually really excited for this video because it's been a really, really long time since I've done a Top 5 video because, like, I've only made 2 Top 5 videos, as you probably saw on my Top 5 playlist on my channel. But in honours of this new year that's going to come, yeah, the new year, 2022, I'm going to count down some of my favourite movies throughout 2021 that I absolutely enjoyed. So without further ado, let's start this. Here we go. So first off, at number 5, we have Space Jam, A New Legacy. This film was created by the infamous Warner Brothers Studios and distributed by Warner Animation Group. The film stars infamous basketball player LeBron James and infamous Looney Tunes character Bugs Bunny. And I generally gotta say, this film is actually really good in my opinion because, to be honest guys, the original Space Jam was released about 25 years ago and it was about time they made a sequel, but the only thing that's different from the original Space Jam is that pretty much every Warner Brothers character that was ever created is in this film. Well, they only make like cameo appearances in this film, such as the Rick and Morty one, which was my absolute favourite, by the way. And some people even saw glimpses of Pennywise the Clown, and also we saw the Iron Giant and King Kong. So, I wonder what you guys are thinking. What's the story about? Well, LeBron James's son was kidnapped by something. Tell me in the comments section below because I don't really know what this thing was actually, who took LeBron James's son. And to get his son back, he has to compete in a basketball contest with a bunch of Looney Tunes characters like in the original. But instead of Michael Jordan, we have LeBron James. Although Michael Jordan does make a cameo in this film, like all the other Warner Brothers characters who make cameo appearances in this movie. And so yeah, this is a very good film in my opinion. Go check it out if you must, because it's a really good film in my opinion, as I already said. I don't know why I keep mentioning that. But still, this is a really fantastic film by any means, and it deserves a great shout out. So up at number 4, we have Luca. This film was created by the Disney company Pixar Animation Studios. The film stars Jacob Tremblay and Jack Dylan Grazer, and this film is widely considered to be the best film of 2021 because of its dry humour, shot compositions and storytelling. And I gotta say, this film is actually really, really good in my opinion. And to top it all off, I'm gonna tell you the story now. The story follows a boy who lives underwater, who is half human and half fish, and whenever he goes into the water, he becomes a sea monster or a fish person. I don't really know what it's called. Just tell me in the comments what you think it might be. And whenever he goes on land, he becomes a normal human being. And yeah, this film is really good. Go check it out if you must. But if you don't have to check it out if you don't want to, but you should, because it's a really damn good film. Now, moving on to number three, we have The Loud House Movie. This film was created by Nickelodeon Movies and distributed by Paramount Pictures. The story follows Lincoln Loud, who thinks his sisters are more special than him, and Clyde gives him some special advice, saying that his ancestors were from France and Lincoln's ancestors were actually from Scotland. So Lincoln and his family travel to Scotland to see if they can find their ancestors. And this film is really good in my opinion, because it also stars David Tennant in it. And I gotta say, David Tennant is one of my most favorite actors in the whole world, because I gotta say, everything that David Tennant voices in, I think he absolutely nails it. And I've always wanted the Loud House Movie to come out, and yep, our wish came true. So go check it out if you like, and you don't have to, like I said with Luca, but this film is really, really amazing. And that, folks, is a guarantee. So now up at number two, we have Godzilla vs. Kong. Now this film is also made by Warner Brothers Studios, like with Space Jam A New Legacy, and was distributed by Legendary Pictures. So this film is about Godzilla and King Kong basically fighting each other. Yeah, that's all the film's about. It's just like the original one. But this one is far, far different from the first Godzilla vs. King Kong. Well, first of all, we have the new King Kong and the new Godzilla. The Godzilla from 2014 and the King Kong from 2017. So, yeah, and also, what's also different about this film is that Mechagodzilla returns in this film. Yep, he makes an appearance as the main antagonist of this film. So, yeah, Godzilla and King Kong basically work together to take down Mechagodzilla, even after all their fighting throughout the whole entire film. And King Kong has a bunch of handy new skills in this film. Like, he's got this axe with one of Godzilla's spikes on it, which he uses to attack other enemies in his sight. And yeah. And Godzilla still looks the same, like his 2014 style. And yeah, this film is really, really good. It has really good ratings online. And And it's just really damn good. I mean, I could just talk about this stuff for hours, man. I mean, I just love this shit. But anyway, guys, now finally for number one. I think many of you guys were expecting this. We have Willy's Wonderland. Now, this film was created by the Soul Entertainment Company, Screen Media. This movie is starring epic stuntman Nicolas Cage, who is working as a janitor in an abandoned family restaurant called, you guessed it, Willy's Wonderland. Now, this film is considered my number one favorite film of 2021, as I will tell you why. One, it's a lot like Five Nights at Freddy's, because we have like killer animatronics, we have a guy working in the restaurant, and the animatronics are trying to kill the guy, but instead of the animatronics killing him, the guy kills the animatronics. So yeah, this film is really damn sweet, and it's really, it might not be a really good horror film, because it's more focused on the action more than horror, but I think it's really good, and it's very, very gory as well, because there's like a lot of disturbing scenes in this film, which you really need to have a very strong stomach. But yeah, also this film does contain a lot of mature content, such as sex and stuff like that. But none of that matters, because I just freaking love this film to the death. So yeah, go check it out right now. So yeah, thanks for watching my top 5 video on my most favourite films of 2021. So I really hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I really hope you subscribe to my channel, like this video, and comment what was your favourite part of this video, and keep being awesome to me. Also, I just want to point out one special thing. I am now selling my own merch. As you can see, here's the YouTube logo, and my name on there is Power Nine Lord. So I'm actually going to make some copies of this shirt, because this is actually a shirt that my dad gave me for Boxing Day. Yeah, Boxing Day was just like, I think 2 days ago, was it? Yeah, it was 2 days ago, or I might be wrong. Maybe it was 1 day ago, but I don't know. Why don't you guys tell me in the comment section below? But anyway, guys, I really hope you enjoyed this video, and sorry if I'm not in my usual house right now. I'm actually staying at my grandmother's for New Year's Day and New Year's Eve. And also, speaking of that, I really hope you guys have an awesome Happy New Year, and I will see you in the next video. So, bye-bye!